Hey guys, I've been MIA for a little bit and a lot of people are asking, where are you? What are you doing? So I'm here to fill in the gaps. October was a busy work month for me, so the beginning of November I was catching up a bit on work. I also went on a semi-spontaneous last minute trip to North Carolina and Virginia. I went with Issei, who's actually from North Carolina, and his favorite Korean restaurant was closing, so we had like a 10-day period where we were like, we need to get over there and eat. It was also the last week his brother-in-law was in town before deploying to the Middle East. I originally intended on vlogging, but I didn't really feel right doing that. It's not that they're unsupportive. Everybody is very supportive of what I do. But I mostly just wanted to be able to experience it fully without a camera. Honestly, Issei's whole family puts my cooking to shame. His dad works in fish, and I probably had the best sushi I've ever had in my entire existence at their house. It was so good, and his dad is so knowledgeable and gave me so much information about everything from aging fish to types of fish to quality control, like everything. It was so interesting to learn about it too. Issei's sister Reina and brother-in-law Kermit live in Virginia, and they are extremely amazing at cooking. It's their hobby. They're both in the Coast Guard, but oh my gosh, I need to talk about what they made because it's so good. They made these smoked chicken tacos with this chili lime sauce that Reina made. That was delicious. That same night, they also made this smoked kimchi burger. Smoked. The burger was smoked. And it had gochujang mayo. In one of the mornings, Kermit made us his famous bananas foster, which was spectacular. And honestly, it was probably some of my favorite food that I've ever had. I really personally like those flavor profiles they used for their food. So I think I just enjoyed it a lot. Also, huge thanks to Taeyong for cooking us Korean food. I haven't had home-cooked Korean food in a while. And it was amazing. She's a culinary student actually in Korea and she's studying English here. So she cooked up such good stuff. I also got to play with Reina and Kermit's two super, super adorable French bulldogs, Loki and Stitch. They are so good. They're so sweet. And I really, really miss them. But yeah, overall, really, really fun, really, really good trip. Thank you so much to the whole Kashima family, including Taeyong, for taking such good care of me and feeding me such good food. After North Carolina, I got sick. It's been 4 weeks to the day, and I'm still getting over it and just starting to feel better. When I got sick, I got really sick, and I looked awful, sounded awful, felt terrible for weeks. It was really, really bad. So I couldn't do anything with like being on camera. I couldn't even go out of the house. I could barely eat. It was no good and I'm still trying to get over it. And on top of being sick, you guys know Jenny. She's been in a lot of my past videos. She is one of my best friends of 12.5 years. And she was also my roommate and she just moved this past week to the UK. So we've been spending weeks organizing the house, getting rid of things, figuring out what she wants to take, figuring out what she wants to keep at her parents' house, and also, I think, emotionally preparing for me to have her leave. She took Castle with her, and I miss them both a lot, but I think they're gonna have a great time in life in the UK. So yeah, it's been a draining couple of months. I'm really exhausted, but it's done. And 2017 is also basically done. So I wanted to do a sort of wrap up for the 2017 to go into the new year. Honestly, 2017 was a really shit year. It was probably one of the more stressful and anxious years that I've had since I started my business like 8 years ago. I am so grateful to have such a good network of friends and family and support. Really, thank you to everyone who was there to support me this year when I was stressed out. And aside from the difficulties and stress, there are a lot of good things that happened this year. I got to play a lot of taiko again, which I've been taking a break from. A lot of my friends who live further away moved closer, so I feel like I've had this sense of community close by that I haven't had in a while. My dear friend Issei finally moved to LA. I got to go to Hawaii with a bunch of people from everywhere. I got to go to Okinawa for the first time. I got to see my family in Japan, which I'm always grateful for. And I also got to go to North Carolina for the first time and go to Virginia. Despite all the difficulties, the hardship, and anxiety, there's always really, really good things. So I put together something small to remind me of all the great people and the great things that I've done this year. I know the format is wrong, but most of these are for my Insta stories or my Snapchat because it's little day-to-day stuff that makes life worth living. I am really, really excited for 2018, and I hope the new year is as amazing for you guys as I am hoping that it will be for me as well. Thank you so much for your support in 2017, and I will see you in the new year. Boy, you look like I hoped you might. Oh my God, it's been a while. 8 long seasons, it's so pleasing, bringing back that sexy smile. I remember that the leaves fell hard that year when we parked on the South Hillside. You pulled me in soft as our lips got lost in a secret that was yours and mine. Then the years fell down, here we are right now. I can see it in those eyes. On your grown up face, feeling out of place. Darling, you could take me back in time. You could take me back in. Darling, you could take me back in.
That was yours and mine. Then the years fell down. Here we are.